We want to create master detail relationship. What is the relationship name? Master detail. We want to go with master detail. So what is this master detail? And why we are going to use it? First, master detail is a one to many relation. Master detail is a one to many relation. One to many relation. What type of relation is this? One to many relation. This master detail can be created only on custom object. Master detail field can be created only on custom object. Master detail field can be created only on custom object. Next, master detail field can be created only on the object which doesn't have any records in it. Master detail field can be created only on the object, only on those objects, those custom objects. Custom objects in which there are no records. Master detail field can be created only on those custom objects in which there are no records available. It is a required field. It is a required field. It is a required field. Again, I repeat. Master detail is one to many relation. This can be created only on custom object. This can be created only on custom object. This can be created only on those objects in which there are no records. That object should not have any data in it. If object has any data, we cannot create. Master detail field can be created only on those objects in which there are no records. In which there are no records. It is a required field. Now let us understand this. It is an employer object. Can I create master detail on this field? Why? There are already two records called employee E01 and employee E02. If the data is already there, we will not be able to create the master detail. Now, employee and payments. Employee and payments. What type of relation? One employee can make n number of payments. So I have employee with the payments. I got it to be payment thing. So, is the payment is a standard object or a custom object? It is a custom object. Can I create a master detail here? Can I create a master detail? Yes. Why? There is no data. I have payment ID. Mode of payment. What is it? Now I have this payment object. In this payment object, do you have any data? There is no data. Only fields are created, but there is no data. In the payment object, there are no data available. Only fields are there. Can I create a master detail? Yes. Master detail can be created on custom object, which does not have any data in it. Master detail can be created on the custom object which does not have any data in it. So what I am doing here? I am creating master detail. What is employee? What is the data type? Mode, bill list, amount, currency, employee. It is what? Master detail. Master detail is a data type like integer, like a number is a data type, date is a data type, bill list is a data type. Checkbox is a data type. Similarly, master detail is also a data type. We can create a field with a data type called master detail only on custom objects which does not have any data in it. So we have created a field. When we created a master detail field, we have created. And I told you, it is a required field. What do you mean by required? You cannot leave the field blank. You are supposed to enter the data. Okay. Now, this is having a relation with which table? Employee table. Now, object in which we have object which is referred to, which is used in the relation employee and payment. Who is the master? It is a master. Who is the child? So, object in which we have created master detail field, that object is called detail object or a child object. What we call it as detail of July detail of object in which we have created. Object in which we have created. Master detail field. Object in which we have created. Master detail field. That object is called detail object or detail object. I hope you are clear. Well, this master detail field is referring to what? The master detail field is referring to one of the object. To which object that master detail field is referring? Employee object. Now that employer become what? That employer become what? Master. Object in which we have created a master detail field, it is a tail object or detail object. Object whose data? Object whose data? Master detail field is referring. That object is called master object. So employee is a master and payment is a detail object. So we have created some records here. Payment 01, mode, online, choose the employee, E01, payment 02, we are going with online, so like this we create it. Now we create it. See, in the amount field, currency value is there. Similarly, in the master detail field, what value will be there? Every field will store some data. Every field will store some data. Every field will store some data. Now, in the master detail field, every field will store the data. In the master detail field, which data is available? Master. Master what? ID of master record. What is stored in the master detail field? 18 character ID. Every record will have 18 character ID. And 18 character ID of the master record will be stored in the master detail field. So what the master detail field will store? Master detail field will store ID of the parent record. Master detail field will store 18 character. Unique ID of the master record. Master detail will store 18 character unique ID of the master record. If I display master ID, you will not be able to understand. There is a reason they are displaying you what? Name field. Whatever the name field is there, that is displayed. But actually, internally, what is there? What is there? ID is there. Master detail field will be storing what? 18 character ID of the master record. Master detail field will store what? 18 character ID of the master record. I hope I am clear? Okay. Next, let us understand. Now, every record will have a owner. Every record will have owner. Look at this. Your accounts. New account. What is it? Account owner, opportunities, new opportunity, what we have? Contracts, new contracts, what are these? So every object will have, every record will have a owner, every record will have a owner. If you look at this diagram, here also give employee 01, owner is job, employee 02, owner is skill. But here, I have not mentioned the owner. Right. What is the reason is, if you create master detail field in any object, that object will not have any owner. If I create a master detail field, if I create a master detail field on any object, that object will not have any owner. Whoever is the owner of the master record, he is the owner of the corresponding tail record. What was the point? If I create master detail field on any object, if I create master detail field on any object, that object will not have any owner. Whoever is the owner of the master record, he will be the owner of the corresponding tail record. Am I clear to this point here? That is the reason the payment object doesn't have any owner field. Every record will have a owner, but the object in which we have created master detail field, that object will not have the owner. Whoever is the owner of the master record, he is the owner of corresponding shared records. In my context, look at this. Employee E01. Who is the owner of the records? Here we have jail records. What are the jail records we have? E01. So who is the owner of the record? Whoever is the owner of the master record, he will be the owner of corresponding shared record. So who is the owner of these two records? Shyam is the owner of the records. So whoever is the owner of the parent record, he is the owner of the corresponding shared record. Now for the P03, who is the owner? Kiran is the owner. I hope you are clear. Right. Let me mention the point. What is the next point here? Object in which we have created master detail field, the object is called, the object is called detail object. Next, object to whose data, object to whose data master detail field is referring. Object to whose data master detail field is referring, the object is called master. The object is called master. Then object in which I have, in which we have created master detail field, object in which we have created a master detail field, that object will not have any owner field. Will not have owner field. Whoever is the owner of the master record, whoever is the owner of the master record, he will be the owner of the corresponding shared record. Whoever is the owner of the master record, he will be the owner of the corresponding shared record. Whoever is the owner of the master record, he will be the owner of corresponding shared record. So look at the points. I hope you are clear. If I create a master detail field on an object, that object will not have any owner. Whoever is the owner of a master record, he is the owner of corresponding shared record. Am I clear with this point? Okay. Look at the point. If I delete any one of the shared record, if I delete P03, it is one of the shared record. If you delete any one of the shared record, then what happened? Record will go to recycle. It's obvious that when you delete a record, it will go to, when I delete any record, it goes to recycle. So P03 is moved to recycle. So if you delete any one of the chain record, corresponding record will go to recycle. The same thing, if I delete any one of the master record, let us see. If I delete any one of the master record, corresponding chain records are also deleted. If you delete a master record, chain records are also deleted. If a master record is deleted, chain records are also deleted. But only master record will be displayed in the recycle bin. When you delete a master, chain records are also deleted, but only master record will be displayed in the recycle bin. When you delete a master record, corresponding chain records are also deleted, but only master record will be displayed in the recycle bin. Everyone clear? Only master record will be displayed in the reset again. Okay. This is how we got it then. So what is that? E01. Now, if I undelete the master record, corresponding change records are also deleted. You delete the master, changes are deleted. You undelete the master, changes will be. Because change cannot exist without master. Change cannot exist without master. As a change cannot exist without master, there is a reason. When a master is deleted, change will be deleted. Go back to the structure. Those are what? Whenever master record is deleted, corresponding change records will be deleted. Whenever the master record is deleted, corresponding change records will be deleted. When you undelete the master record, whenever master record is undeleted, corresponding change records are also undeleted. Whenever the master record is undeleted, corresponding change records are also undeleted. The next we have. Look at the next point. How many master delay fields we can create? Only two master delay fields are enough. Similarly, listen to the following. Can an object be a master to more than one object? Can an object be a master to more than one object? Look at the structure. Can an object be a master to more than one object? Well, yes, it can. Let us see the diagonal representation first. Can an object be a parent to more than one object? Yes, it can be. Now, on P, I created master delay. Look at the structure. P. On the P object, we created a master delay to A. P is a child, A is a master. Where did we create a field? On the P we created. On C we created. Now, who is the master to the P here? A is the master. Who is the master to the C here? A. Same object is master to two objects. Now, for B master is A, for C master is A, for A also master is A. The same object is master to more than one object. Is it accepted? Yes, it is accepted. Right. Then, can we have more than two master delay fields? Can we have more than two master delay fields? For an object? Can we have more than two master delay fields on an object? Look at the point. Understand the structure? So, can we have more than one object as a master? Look at the form. For B, who is the master? For is the master. Now, for C, who is the master for C? A is the master, B is the master. Where I am creating a master detail field? Master detail field is created on C. One master detail field to one master detail field to A, other master detail field to B, right master? So how many master detail fields we have created here? On this object, how many master detail fields we created? Two master. Is it accepted?
Yes.
Is it accepted? Yes, it is accepted. Accepted? Accepted. Why? On an object, maximum only master detail fields we can have? Only two. But on the C, we have three fields. Is it accepted? No. Next one. Okay. Can a child object be a parent to any other object? Can a child object be a parent to any other object? Can a child object be a parent to any other object? Look at the structure. A. So, for A, B is a child. Can a B be a parent to anyone? Now, B is a child of A. Can a B be a parent to anyone?
Yes.
Can a child of A be a parent to any other object?
Yes.
No problem. Can a subchild be a parent to any other object? Any subchild? No problem. One question is, can a child object be a parent to any other object? Can a child object be a parent to any other object? First one. Accepted? Yes. Only one level. How many levels are there? The next one. Accepted? Yes. Next one. Accepted. Then accepted. Right. Why? Only up to three levels we can accept. A is a child of B. Sorry. B is a child of A. C is a child of B. D is a child of C. Only three levels. So child object can be a parent to any other object up to how many levels? Three levels. Any other object? Yes, sir. Up to 3 levels. A child object can be a parent to any other object up to how many levels? 3 levels. Child object can be a parent to any other object up to 3 levels. A child object can be a parent to any other object up to how many levels? 3 levels. Right. Let us go to the next. Can a function object A, parent to can a junction object be a parent to any other object? What do you mean by junction object? Look at the format. A is a parent to B of A. Look at the structure. Now tell me, Whether the first one is accepted? First one is accepted? Second one is accepted? Second one is accepted? Now look at the third one. If an object has any, if an object has two parents on it, can it be a parent to either object? A to B, B to C, accepted? Yes, it is accepted. A to A and B are parent to C, accepted? Yes, an object can have two parents. A and B are parent to C. Now can C be a parent to D? No, it is not. What is that? If an object has any, if an object has two masters on it, it cannot be a parent to either object. If an object has two masters on it, it cannot be a master to any other object. What is the first condition? Accepted. Second condition? Accepted. Third condition? Accepted. Why? Any object which has two masters has two masters on it, cannot be a parent to any other object. Any object which has two masters on it, cannot be a parent to any other object. I hope I am clear with this one. So next, what is the maximum structure we can form? What is the maximum structure we can form? Maximum structure is maximum structure. This is the maximum structure. A to B, B to C, C to D. Three levels accepted. B has two parents, C and Z. B has two parents, C and Z. So this is the maximum structure what we can form using the master relay. Directly or indirectly, this is the maximum structure what we can form. Directly or indirectly, this is the maximum structure what we can form. So these are the quick points on the master relay. I hope you got every structure. All these are there in your hard copies. You got to write the diagrams. All the points I mentioned the hard copies what I have given. Right, folks? Clear? Okay. Now, let us understand second structure. Let us understand the next structure. Let us understand the next structure. We have the next point. Everyone is clear about this? Everyone is clear? Let me revise the points till now what we covered. Once again, master detail is what? 1-2 many relation. Master detail field can be created only on custom object. It can be created only on those objects which don't have any data. Only on those objects which does not have any data in. Then we have master detail field can be created only on custom object. Master detail field can be created only on those objects which does not have any data. It is a required field. It is a required field. Master detail field can store 18. What the data will be stored? Master detail field will store 18 character ID of the parent record. The field, what data will be stored? Field will store the data. But what data will be stored? 18 character ID of the master record will be stored. What will be stored? 18 character ID of the master record will be stored. 18 character ID of the master record will be stored in master detail field. Okay, the next object in which we have created a master detail field, that object is called single object. Object to whose data I am referring, that object is called master object. Then if you create a master detail field on an object, then what will happen? Then will not have any owner. Whoever is the owner of a master record is the owner of corresponding jail record. If I delete a master record, corresponding jail records are deleted. But they will not be displayed in recipient. When I undelete the master record, corresponding jail records will be undeleted. corresponding guilty parts will be adjacent. Right. The next. Then we have, how many master radial fields we can create? Two master radial fields we can create. So, an object can be a master to more than one object? Yes. It can be a master to more than one object. Okay. Can we have more than two master radial fields? Can we have more than two master radial fields on an object? No. What is the maximum we can create? Two master radial fields. On C, we can have A and B. On D, A, B, C is great. Next. Can a tailed object be a parent to any other object? Can a tailed object be a parent to any other object? Yes, up to how many level? Three levels. Right. If an object has two masters on it, can it be a master to any other object? No, it cannot be a master to any other object. What is the maximum structure of a master detail? We go up to three levels, to the power of three levels. People are clear? Clear? Okay. Now, listen to the next point. Listen carefully. Listen carefully, boss. In my company, in my organization, I have four employees. There are four employees. There are four employees. I have some employee table. In the employee table, I have a record. Employee 01. Let us say I have some more. Some data is there. This is a record which we have in the employee table. On this record, Wilson have write permission. What is the permission Wilson has? Wilson cannot modify the data, he can only see the data. Faraz also has a same permission. What is the data? On this data? Can they create a new record? They cannot create a new record. They can only have a permission of read. Whereas Divya, if you take, Divya has read and write permission. Divya can modify the data of employee. Shyam, when you take, he don't have the permission to see the record. Shyam is not able to see E01. Wilson and Faraz are able to see E01, but they can only see the data, they cannot modify the data. Another question. Who can create jail records for this? For this E01, E01 is a master. For this master, who can create a chain records? Who is allowed to create a chain records? Who is allowed to modify the chain records? Who can delete? So permissions are what? Create, edit, delete. Permissions are fixed. What are permissions? Create, edit, delete. We are not speaking about permissions. We are speaking about which person will have this permission? Permissions are what? Permissions are three. Whether you get all the three or none of them. You get all the three or none of them. What are the three permissions? Create, edit, delete. Permissions are fixed. Create, edit, delete. All the three will be coming to you or none will be coming to you. You will get all the three or none. All the three permissions will come to you or none. So it's not the question about which permission. The question about which person is going to get in this group of 150 students, which student has a permission to create this jail record? Out of these 150 students, which student has a permission to create a jail record? So now it is not important about what permission. It's the importance of which person. To tell that, we have two options. Sharing series. There are two options. You are supposed to select any one option. First option is read only. Any user in the organization who has at least taxes on any user in the organization who has at least a read access on master record can perform create, edit, read operation on process. Any user in the organization who has at least read access on the master record can perform create, edit, delete on corresponding field record. This is the first permission. If I choose this permission, what will happen? If I choose this permission, suppose I select this permission. You select this. Any user in the organization who has at least a read, minimum read, who has Wilson has, Paras has, Divya has. So all the three people can perform create, edit, delete on the corresponding jail record. For this master, they can create a jail, edit the jail, delete the jail record. Suppose, any user in the organization who has at least read and write form create, edit, delete operations on so, the second one. If I choose this option, who can perform? Any user in the organization who has at least a read write. Who has at least a read write? Only Divya. So, if I choose this, only Divya can perform create, edit, and delete on jail records. If I choose this, Divya, Wilson, Paras. Right? Or any more point. This is called sharing set. This is called as what? Sharing set. Or any more point? It is for everyone? Okay. Let me show this in terms of execution. Now let us start. How to create a master table? So we have got employee table. First let me create object. Don't have a ticket. So go back to the next one. What you have created? You get an object called. Now loan is a chain to employee. I want to create a loan as a chain to employee. One employer can take a number of loans. Now is it a must to tell which employer has taken the loan? Without specifying the employee, can I give the loan? No, it's a mandatory. It's a one too many and a mandatory. So what are we? Custom fields and relation. Before creating the master detail, look at this. We have the owner field. And the loan, we have a owner field. Because we have not created a master detail, we have a owner field. Now I am creating a master detail. Custom fields and relation. New. Master. What is the object? What is the object? What is the object? Who is the master? Employee is the master. Employee is the master. Object is master. Now let me show share relationship. Now sharing city. What is the sharing city? Select the minimum access level required and the master to create edit or delete register. So what about this? Read only access or read and write access. Read only access or read and write access. What is required? What is the minimum permission required to perform create, edit, delete operation on the shared record? Sharing settings. Now we are not touching these 2 points right now. Next. Next. Go to what happened? Employee is a required field. When you click on the icon, you are able to see employee data. You are able to see employee data. Does it have any owner field now? No. So, master detail field can be created only on custom object. It can be created only on the object which does not have any data. Then, it is a required field. It is a required field. What will be stored in this field? ID of the master record. What will be stored? ID of the master record. The next point is, if I create a master detail field, owner will not be there. If I create a master detail field, owner will not be there. Now I save it. If you go to the employee object, it is an employee. Under the employee we have, what is employee? This is the loop, right? Now I am creating the employee. If I create a master record, go to the loads and see. Are you finding any load record? No load. When? Because when you create a master record, shared records are also. Go to this segment. What is coming? Only master record is coming. If you undelete the master record, go to the loads. We are finding that. So when you delete a master record, shared records are also deleted. But the deleted shared records will not be displayed in the this segment. When you undelete the master record, shared records are also undeleted. I hope you got the point. Let me take the next. Okay. We have created a relation with the shared record. Only look up. That's all. Only the icon will display. That's all. Right. We have created some data here. So I am creating some employee data. Usually I have only one employee. So I am creating multiple employee data now. I'm creating some sample data. To explain the next point, I'm creating some sample data again. Now, let me create one more field. So, I'm creating some sample data here. Right. So, in the employee object, we have a couple of fields here. Now go to the loan. When you go to the loan, trying to create a new loan, what do you find? This is called relation. Open the object and see the field. You want to see how did you open my object? You open an employee object. Now you want to see the fields of loan? Open the loan object. Fields will be displayed. What is the question there? Right. Fine. One more point. Let's go to the loan. You are going to a loan. So you are selecting now. When you are selecting, what is happening now? You got a group of employees. Now I don't want to show all the employees. I don't want to show all the employees. I want to show only Hyderabad employees in this box. When I click on this icon, all the employees data is coming. So I don't want to show the employee data. I want to show only Hyderabad employee data. So what I will do? You created a look. Okay. Go to this. What are the field we created? Employee. Master detail field we created. Click on the edit. When I click on the edit. Now I told lookup filter is there. What is lookup filter? Now tell me which records of the parent should be displayed in the pop-up window. Right now every record is displayed. Lookup filter. Select this. Say employee city equals to employee city equals to select employee city equals to Hyderabad. Then previously how many records are coming? 5 records. Now click on this. So which records are coming? Why? Because we told which records of the master should be displayed. What is the field we created? Only one field. What is that? Employee. What is the data type? Master detail. Click on the edit, go to the lookup filter and say which records you want to show. Right now I told instead of Hyderabad, I want to go with Bangalore. So previously how many records you are able to see? 3 records. Now you will be finding 2 records. So as per the condition we give, corresponding records will be visible. Is that was clear for everyone? Everyone is clear? If you don't want, what we do? Click on edit. You don't want the filter? So that will be fine. Lookup filter. What is the purpose of lookup filter? In the pop-up window, which records of the master should be displayed? That is called as lookup filter. The next we have one more point. Look at the point. I have created a loan record, right? Who is the parent for it? Employee number 00. What is the parent? Later on I decided I have to change my parent. Child record is created. After the child record is created, I have decided I have to change my parent. Can it change or not? Once the child record is created, are you allowed to modify your parent? Look at the point. What is the reason? Once a child is created, you are not supposed to change your parent. But I have a business requirement where I have to modify my parent. Then what I will do? Go to the field, click on edit. You have there. What is allow? If I enable this option, once a child record is created, if you want to change your parent, you can change it. Allow reparenting. Once the child record is created, if you want to change your parent, you can change it. What is this? Click on this. Are you able to modify? Right. So what are the two options? Lookup filter. Which records of the master should be displayed in the pop-up window? Which records of the master should be displayed in the pop-up window? Which is called lookup filters. Okay. Then we have what is it? Allow reparenting. Once the child record is created, Do you want to change your parent? Yes, it is allowed. Provided if you enable the option called allow reparenting. Once the child record is created, can I change my parent? Yes, you can change your parent. Provided if you enable the option called allow reparenting. Is that was clear? People have followed this? Okay. Then I have a difficulty over here. What is the difficulty? When I click on the new, we are getting the icon. Click on this. This employee number is coming. Based on this number, I cannot identify who are you. I am finding it difficult to identify who are you. So if you only display employee number, it is very difficult for me. So what I have to do? I have to show some more data. Are you getting my point? Now how to show the data? Boss, if you are using me, who I am? Employee. Who I am? Employee. If you are using me as a master, then which fields of my records should be displayed in the pop-up window? If you use me as a master, employee loan, who is the master? Employee. On the employee object, Go to the employee object, scroll down. What you are finding here? Search. In the search field, what you have? Look up. Click on edit. Select which fields you want to display. First name, last name. Then go to the loan object now. You are able to see couple of, right? What is it? Which fields of the master object? Which fields of the master object should be displayed in the lookup window? Which fields of the master object should be visible in the lookup window? That we can control from search layout. That we can control from search layout of the master. Am I clear with this concept? Okay. Let me revise all the points. Once again, I'll revise all the points. What is a master detail relation?